A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th November, on the front page you have Delhi police stage protest after attacks on their colleagues. So 11 agitation took place and it was called off after assurance by senior officers to address the grievances. So you can see thousands of Delhi police personnel laid siege to the forces headquarters for 11 hours. So it was a virtual revolt sparked by two attacks on colleagues. So you can see families of the personnel also took to the streets. There were two attacks on police personnel, one on Monday outside Saket District Court and another on Saturday in the Tis Hazari Courts complex. So parking dispute between a on-duty policeman and a lawyer led to at least 20 security personnel and several advocates being injured. Then this is, could join RCP if demands are met, says Piyush Goyal. So this is Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal, who has said that RCP, India may join RCP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, if demands of India are met. But decision to stay out is final for now. So presently, we are going to stay out. On page 9, you have, economic slowdown may lighten India's carbon burden. So carbon dioxide emissions are poised to grow at their slowest since 2001 due to lower demand for coal in power and manufacturing sectors. So this is what a study speaks of, in the context of economic slowdown, that carbon dioxide emissions, the rate of growth would be slowest since 2001. So here you can see India's carbon dioxide emissions in first 8 months of 2019 show that they grew by 2%, which is slowest since 2001. Then below you have Indian lungs under extreme stress. So acute respiratory infections affect children the hardest, say experts, because of pollution. You can see, so acute respiratory infections account for 69.47% of morbidity as such in 2018. Which was highest in the communicable diseases category. That is, you can see, this is acute respiratory infections. And this is in ban proposed on sale ads of junk food in schools. So this is Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, which has released draft regulations titled Food Safety and Standards, Safe Food and Healthy Diets for School Children Regulation 2019, aimed at enabling children to eat and grow healthy. So junk food ad and sale in schools will be banned. On the editorial page, the first editorial is safe for now. So this is regarding RCP. So it says India has its reasons to stay out of the RCP, but tariff walls cannot remain high. So India has opted out of Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement. That was the front page news yesterday, and even today's paper has news regarding it. So this is an editorial on that okay, we have stayed out of RCP, but the tariffs which we impose on imports from other countries, they cannot be high. Tariff walls cannot remain high for long, because eventually we have to rationalize. So, because Chinese goods especially have given competition to India, so we have to face that, because eventually we'll have to open. Then this is back to the blackboard. So this is regarding NEET, National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test for medical college admissions. So this NEET entrance exam, it says NEET puts the poor at a disadvantage, but the focus must be on quality of school education. So NEET is a competitive exam, and Tamil Nadu actually had banned competitive entrance exams, and because of NEET, Tamil Nadu reluctantly has joined it. But then it says poor are at a disadvantage, they cannot join costly coaching institutes. But then the editorial says that focus must be on quality of school education. So if quality of school education improves, then there would not be any need for special training for competitive exams. And the lead article is, what makes doing business easier? So this talks of the viability of a business, how it depends on the vitality of the economy in which it is embedded. So business cannot function well if the economy is severely affected. So that is it. And below you have, down but still a potent terror force. So this is talking about how India should keep vigil over developments in West Asia regarding the Islamic State, because though Islamic State is presently down, but it's still a potent terror force. So we know what has been happening in West Asia, in Syria. Turkey invaded the region, Russia has come forth. Turkey has said that they would send back the IS prisoners as such, the terrorist related prisoners, back to their countries. So that raises fears as such. Then on the OPIT page you have a victory for the dairy sector. So this is how RCEP would have affected the dairy sector, which the Indian government has also mentioned. So the key fear of the dairy sector was the tariff clauses for agriculture in the RCEP at a much more severe compared to the existing WTO agreement. So WTO allows countries to fix tariffs up to a certain maximum or bound tariff for a given commodity line, but RCEP binds countries to reduce that level to zero within the next 15 years. So countries, India's average bound tariff for dairy products presently is 63.8%, while its average applied tariff is 34.8%. So bringing them down to near zero levels will be difficult in 15 years. So stepping out of RCEP means India is a victory for the dairy sector, but it says government should remain guarded against temptations of free trade agreements like RCEP. But then we also, as the editorial also said, we also have to improvise our own sectors to such an extent that we also become competitive globally. Then this is providing sexuality education. So it says sex education as such will prepare children to recognize inappropriate behavior and promptly report such behavior. On page 12 you have Ayodhya case, RSS Muslim leaders meet. So at a discussion presided over by a minister, that is Minorities Affairs Minister Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, all agreed that the verdict should be accepted peacefully. And then below you have shutting down of landlines in Kashmir Valley raised in Supreme Court. So this is an issue which has been raised in Supreme Court, that people were unable to call in a time of need. So landlines were shut down. And below you have Dalit activists campaign against Twitter on discrimination. So company states that it has one set of rules and it enforces them impartially, but Dalit activists have accused it of promoting and condoning caste discrimination and hierarchy. So social media platform Twitter is in the eye of storm now. So it's called Twitter Hates SC, ST, OBC Muslims. So this was among the top trends, and on Monday it was Jai Bhim, Jai Mandal, Jai Birsa, denoting a coalition of Dalits, OBCs and tribals. So these are the hashtags which are now trending, casteist, Twitter, etc. So activists say that immediate trigger for the campaign was Twitter's abrupt decision to restrict the handle of Dilip Mandal, who is an academic, journalist and author who champions social justice causes online. So his account was disabled by Twitter. So the Twitter said there were privacy violations. And in March 2019, he had tweeted about a booklet titled Bahujan Agenda. So the author had explicitly given him permission to tweet his contacts, but Twitter cited it a violation of rules and restricted his account. Then on page 13, again you have RCEP related news. China also says we are ready to address India's concerns on RCEP. So it says the agreement would help both countries, India and China. And this is Gujarat anti-terror bill gets president's nod. So President Ramnath Kovind has given his assent to Gujarat control of terrorism and organized crime bill, which is a controversial anti-terror legislation passed by the BJP ruled state in 2015. One of the key features of this new act is interception of telephonic conversations that would be considered legitimate evidence now under this bill. So president has to give his assent, which has been provided. Then on international page you have Trump urges war on Mexico cartels after 9 Americans killed. So US President Donald Trump offered to help Mexico wage war on its cartels after 3 women and 6 children from an American community, Mormon community, were murdered in an area notorious for drug traffickers. So gunmen ambushed a group of Mormons, killing women and children. This is an incident which has taken place in Mexico. And this is crackdown concessions fail to quell Chile protests. So we are seeing the South American country of Chile under protest. Demonstrators are demanding welfare and a new constitution. And this is US begins formal pullout from Paris deal. So US has announced that it will withdraw from Paris climate accord, but now this withdrawal, which will take a year, so the process has been formally begun now. So it will be just after the 2020 US presidential elections that US will be formally out of the Paris climate agreement. And this is Trump invites Xi to US to sign trade agreement. So US President Donald Trump has invited his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping to sign the phase 1 of bilateral trade deal, which has been agreed upon. So the trade war which is going on between USA and China has now seen phase 1 of a trade deal being signed. The two countries actually have failed to reach any agreement to resolve the trade dispute. So the Trump has slapped huge tariffs on Chinese goods, and a tit for tat has come from US, from China as such. So trade talks have begun. It began in November 2018, but have not yielded desired results even after more than dozen rounds of negotiations. So Trump has invited Xi Jinping to US so to see if they are able to sign a deal, phase one of the trade agreement. And they said we are close to the agreement. It's not, even the phase one is not completed yet. On business page you have government RBI working on realty reforms. Finance minister has said that sector, realty sector, will be given much importance due to its spillover effect. Alternative funds are keen to work with realty sector. So this is announced. And here you have exporters industry laud India's decision to pull out of RCEP. So this is again in the context of regional comprehensive economic partnership agreement, which India opted out of. So that decision is praised. So that is it. Then even the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.